Assalamu alaikum. So today is the lecture number 3 of the series Python and Machine Learning. So today's topic is user input and data types. So let's begin. So in Python, user inputs is done by an input method. So for example, x equal to input, enter first value. And when you enter the value, it will take the input from the user. And you can take as much as inputs as you want. As we can see, here is the enter first value, and then enter second value, and so on. And then we can perform whatever operations we can do with those user inputs. Okay, so let's start with the list. Basically, list is the collection which is ordered and changeable. In Python list, data are written with the square brackets. Okay, it can have any number of items, and there may be different data types for integer, float, string, etc. So basically, list is the collection in which we have the items that can have of any data type. Okay, so a list can also have another list as an item. So we can create the list within the list. So if we see simple list, it is like num equal to brackets. So these brackets are used for list 10 20 30. If we print nums, it will print us 10 20 30, what is in the list, it will print that. So we can create this, and we can access any elements of that list. If you say nums equal to nums 1 to 3, it will print index of first element and third element, means 20 and 30. So yes, we can store the names, or you can say the strings also in this in the list: Ahmed, Abbas, Hasnain, Ali. Okay, so then if we will print the names, it will print the names stored in the list. Okay, how we will print the list in Python? There are many ways to print the list in the Python. There are four popular ways, so let's see. So first of all, we can print the list using the loop or for loop. We can start from 0 to the length of the list, and we can print all of the elements in the list one by one. So how we can do that? You can see if there is a list with elements a equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So if we will loop it like for x in range length of a, it will start from 0 and go for the length of the list. In this example, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4, means 5 elements are there starting from 0 to 5. So it will output the 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is the first way to print the list in Python. So what is the second way without using loops? Obviously, the first way was to using the loops, and the second way is to without using the loop. Asterisk symbol is used to print the list element in a single line with space. So if you will use the asterisk symbol in the list, it will print the all element without any middle element and with the space. To print all elements in the new line or separated by space, use sep equal to backslash n or sep equal to simply comma. So if we have the list elements a equal to 1 2 3 4 5, and we will print like asterisk a, so it will print 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with space. Okay? Okay. So if we will use another argument like sep equal to quotations and comma, so it will print all the elements with the comma in between. Another way is to print all the elements in the new line. So for doing that, we will just use separator equal to backslash n, which is the new line keyword. So it will also print the all element in a separate line. So these are some ways to print the list in Python. Okay, another way is to convert a list to a string for display. Okay, so for example, if you have a list, you can convert it into a string to display. So if it is a list of a string, we can simply join them using join function. But if the list contain integers, then convert it into a string and then use join function to join them to a string and print the string. For example, you have a list A equal to geeks for geeks. There are three elements. So if you will print it using the dot join and then you pass the argument as argument of a list, so it will print geeks for geeks. Okay, if you will convert it into an integer and then print it, it will print you 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The last way is print list in Python is using map. So map is the function which can be used to print the list in Python. How? If you have element A equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and you will just print dot join map and stra, it will print the elements of the list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so if you want to print in a new line, you have to use map str comma a and backslash n to print it a new line. Okay, another popular way or a collection in Python is tuple. Okay, so in tuple, the objects are separated by commas. In some ways, a tuple is similar to a list in terms of indexing or nested objects or repetition, but there is one difference. A tuple is immutable. As list or mutable, you can change the elements of list at any time, but you can't change the tuple elements at all. Okay, so once they are created, they are created. You can't change it. So one way of creation of tuple is to tup, this is the variable name, you can use any tup equal to python comma geeks, and if you will print, it will print python and geeks. So there is another way to use the tuple or to print the tuple is use these brackets. Okay, so it will print the same python and geeks for you. So what is the difference between tuple and list? So the difference is tuples are immutable, they can't be changed once created, but the lists are mutable, they can be changed, its elements can be updated. Okay, so list uses these brackets and tuples use these brackets. Iteration in tuple is faster than list because of immutability. Obviously tuple is faster than list because you can't change the elements, so it will be faster to iterate it. Tuple support only two functions, namely count and index. Count tell the number of occurrences of any element. If you will use the count, it will tell you how many elements are there in the tuple with index return to the index of any given number set. So if we talk about mathematically, a set is a collection of items not in a particular order. Okay, so order doesn't matter. A Python set is similar to this mathematical definition but with some conditions. So here are the conditions. Number one, the elements in the set cannot be duplicates. You can't duplicate the elements. If you use an element, if you have, let's suppose, a set of 1, 2, 3, you can't use 1, 2, 3 again. Okay, you can't repeat it, you can't duplicate it. The elements in the set are immutable, cannot be modified. Okay, but the set as a whole is mutable. You can change the set, but the elements in the set individually cannot be modified, they are immutable. Okay, there is no index attached to any elements in the Python set, so they do not support any indexing or slicing operation. Okay, so if you see the previous two collections, list and tuple, they have the indexes attached. You can access the access or slicing operation on list and tuple B, but you can't use it on set because it doesn't support the indexing. Okay, the sets in Python are typically used for mathematical operations, obviously, like union, intersection, and differences, and complements, etc. You can create a set, access it element, and carry out these mathematical operations as shown. Creating a set, how you will create a set? A set is created by using the set function. Simply, if you will create this set, you can use the set function. Or placing all the elements within a pair of curly brackets. You can also use the curly bracket to use the set or to create the set. You can use the set method or you can use the curly brackets as well. So let's take this example. Has a way of creating a set. Day is equal to set. We are using the set function. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, up to Sunday. There is another method to create the set, like curly brackets. We haven't used set in this. We are just using the curly brackets and it will automatically create the set. So January, February, March and this. Then we can also create the integers set. Okay, 21, 22, 17. So if we will print all these, it will result as three sets. One is days, second is months, and third is dates. Days, month, and dates. So how we can access the values in the set? Can also get a list of individual elements by looping through the set. So if you want to print the elements of a set, you can loop through it. Okay. So for example, there is a set by naming days, and elements are Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, up to Sunday. If you will use the for loop for d in days means the set, you will print the d, you can have all the elements, all the items of the sets printed. Okay, adding items to a set. So if you have a set, you have Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. If you will use days dot add Sunday and you will print days, it will add the Sunday. Removing items from a set. How we can remove the item? So if you have a days equal to set Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, up to Saturday, so this function dot discard is used to remove the any item from the set. You just write the type name of the set and you will print it, it will remove. Okay, so for adding you will use dot add, for discard you will use dot discard. From start, what we have learned? First of all, we have user input, in which we can see how we can take the input from the user. Then we have a list. List is a collection which is changeable. We can change the list, and how we can create the list, how we can access the list. Then there are different ways to print the items in the list using the for loop. Second is without using the loop, or we can use the separator item. Then we have convert a list to a string for display. Then we can use the method map to print the list. Then we have a tuple. Tuple is same like the list, but its objects are immutable, or its elements are immutable. You can't change it. Then we have a tuple versus list difference. Then we have a set. Set is another collection in Python which is similar to list and tuple, but with some changes. So the items of set are cannot be duplicated. We can't duplicate the items, and immutable. They are immutable. We can't change it. This is the way of creating a set. This is way of accessing the values in a set by using the loop, and then we can add the item and then we can remove the item from the set. So this is all from today's lecture. Hope you have learned. Thank you so much.